Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. Glad you could attend. And today on the block, well, we've got an independent horror comedy film. Prepare yourself. It's called Easter Casket. That's right, Easter Casket. Now, there's a group of religious folks who want to hold a meeting with the religious leaders and want to do away with the Easter imagery, the Easter bunny, the baskets, the chocolate, the jelly beans, the whole nine yards. They want to get rid of that and just make it kind of a solemn religious holiday. Well, Peter Cottontail doesn't like that. He shows up and lets his voice be heard through blood-curdling screams of the nuns and other religious folk that he dispatches in gruesome, nasty, gory ways. Okay, the only thing stopping the Easter Bunny from completing his plan is Father Asher, a warrior for the Lord, who is sent by the Mega Pope to go stop Peter Cottontail. As you can tell by the characters in the story alone, folks, this horror comedy is definitely not going to be for everyone, okay? But if you're any fan of the horror independent genre who like the no-holds-barred, no-restriction comedy that independent horror can bring to you, then definitely Easter Casket needs to be on your list. First off, you got this cast who does wonderfully with the script that they have. The humor comes at you like that, and they do very well with the material and into their characters. The guy, Josh Ale playing Father Asher, loved his character, this kind of cold soldier for the Lord who's very faithful to his faith. For lack of a better term, and I just loved his portrayal and his character. And then you have great chemistry between him and Aaron R. Ryan's Aubrey Burke. Aubrey is a girl that's kind of tagging along with this religious group that wants to do away with Easter, and you know, she's kind of like, well, you know, maybe we want to keep the Easter Bunny around and that. So she's a great, compliment to the Father Asher cold religious character, you know. And then you have the wild Father Crow, played by Jason Crow, which, by the way, out there, Disney, if you're looking for a brother of Mark Hamill, Luke Skywalker's brother, pick Jason Crow, all right? I saw him, and he looked kind of like a Luke's kind of more seedy brother, if you will, and I love his Father Crow character. He's got a great scene in there with, I believe it's Ronnie Jonah as Sister Mary Joan in there, and they do great. I love their scene. It was very hilarious, like most of this film. It's not a serious horror film in any way. It's a send-up. It's an ode. It's in the vein of other exploitation films before it. You have great humor and some fantastic fun performances, and you throw in gratuitous amounts of nudity as well as gore and blood. Now, there was some CGI blood, which I don't necessarily care for, but in this film, it was done fairly well. Okay, there's only a few spots where it's like, okay, you know, but for the most part, they handled the CGI blood very well, so I was surprised there as how well they did it. There are also just a few scenes in there that were a little bit too choppy for me, especially with the audio track. So just a few scenes in there that weren't maybe edited, might be a little bit tighter in their editing. But overall, Easter Casket is a lot of fun. I had a wild ride with this movie and definitely want it in my Easter basket this holiday season. And you will too once you see it. Fans of exploitation films and low-budget independent horror comedies, this is definitely one for you. Those who may be offended by religious humor, by portrayal of folks of faith being portrayed inappropriately, you may want to skip this one because you could be offended by it. But those out there who aren't offended by that, definitely put Easter Casket on your list. It is just another gem of independent horror out there, and proof positive that you'll at least get more original material out of the independent horror scene than you will out of Schlollywood. And, definitely put it on your list. And that'll about do it for us here at Final Cut. Till next time, keep that ticket.